Making quantum computers suitable for everyday use is the goal of many research groups worldwide. This also includes the miniaturization of individual components. The experimental physicist Silke Auchter is working at the University of Innsbruck to optimize the heart of the quantum computer, the ion trap, for industrial production. Quantum computers work with qubits. These qubits are provided by the ion traps.
In a quantum computer, you need a basis like the classical bit in a classical computer, and this is the quantum bit, the qubit. And this qubit can be formed by an ion. And in our ion traps, we trap these ions. We try to confine these ions in the trap so that we can use them as a qubit. And this can be done through their electronic states, their energy states. And in these states, we can encode the qubit information or do the operations. To operate an ion trap, you of course need electronics for your static and your radio frequency voltages, and you also need optics. So you need lasers to cool your ion down to the ground state, and you need lasers to do the readout to see in which state you are, in which electronic state you are with your ion. And you also need lasers for the manipulation, for doing the quantum operations. Yeah, currently the lab is quite huge and we need a lot of equipment. So this is also one goal, to reduce this whole lab and make it smaller.
At the university, the scientists are working on a new generation of semiconductor-based ion traps in the size of microchips. They will replace the much larger ion traps used previously.
Previous ion traps are macroscopic traps, so most of university groups are working with macroscopic traps. But we want to scale our ion traps, so we want to make our ion traps smaller. And this is why we do the microfabrication at Infineon. So our ion traps are just like on a very tiny microchip, and we can trap several ions on one of these tiny chips. The goal of our project is to build a scalable ion trap. So this means we want to trap a lot of ions. And we do this by building an ion trap where we have individual trapping sites. So every ion is trapped on a single trapping site, and therefore we can couple ions not only in one direction but also in two directions. And so we could end up with a huge array of ions that could be used for quantum operations.
The focus is on the internal structure of the ion traps, i.e. their architecture. The way the electrodes are arranged determines how well and under which conditions the ions can be kept in their places. Silke Auchter is trying to put the academic ideas and requirements into a form that can be manufactured in industrial facilities. The project partner, Infineon Technologies, which produces the ion traps in Villach, is helping to implement the project.
The microfabrication of such ion traps is not easy, especially not in a university clean room. So there you're very limited in different fabrication processes you can take, and also in the precision. And we use therefore the fabrication at Infineon because they can guarantee a high precision and also a high reproducibility, so that in the end every of our ion traps is completely the same. And we end up with having a lot of completely identical ion trap chips that can be operated, therefore, much easier.
Individual ion trap chips are separated from the wafer plate and further processed under clean room conditions. At this time, the wire bonding has to be done by hand in the scientific laboratory, but will be fully automated in the near future. Each electronic contact of the ion trap has to be bonded to the carrier board with wire as thin as a hair.
The next steps are, of course, to trap even more ions, because in the end you would need hundreds or thousands of ions to build like a general, fully functioning quantum computer. So we are working iteratively, so we're trying to improve our traps as soon as we have feedback from the trap characterization in the lab. And so hopefully in a few years we are closer to a fully functional quantum computer. In my PhD, I'm also looking into different architectures one could use for building an ion trap. There you can use a two-dimensional structure like we have right now, where you have single trapping sites in two arrays. And the second project is to build a three-dimensional ion trap, so to have a 3D architecture. There you have not only one layer where the electrodes sit, but multiple layers with electrodes. And this means that the ion can be confined even stronger in the ion trap. And this is very important if you want to go to a room temperature operation. So this means that you could operate your ion trap at room temperature and you do not have to cool it down to cryogenic temperatures around 10 Kelvin.
Cooling to temperatures below minus 260 degrees Celsius would then be obsolete, a further step towards widespread availability of quantum computers. Silke Auchter is currently doing her PhD. The project is funded by the EU within the Horizon 2020 project Piedmons. Other partners are ETH Zürich and the Italian e-mobility company IFEVS.